In this lecture, I would like to discuss the expression for EMF of electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cations. In electrolyte concentration cell, as there is a transfer of ions from one half cell to the other half cell is takes place. In electrolyte concentration cell, there is a transfer of cations and anions are takes place from one half cell to the other half cell. So this is the one of the kind of the chemical change. This is one of the kind of the chemical change in the electrolyte concentration cell. So let us consider the example of electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cation. So the cell which is given here, it is electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cation. So the cell consists of two same gas electrodes, while the activity of the electrolytes are different. The two same electrolytes are having the different activities, A1 and A2. Now, in this case, A1 is greater than A2. It means the concentration of HCl of this compartment, it is greater as compared to this compartment. So there is a transfer of cation will be takes place from LHS to RHS. Hydrogen ions are moving from LHS to RHS. And to complete the circuit, chloride ions are moving from RHS to LHS. So let us going to derive the derivation for this type of the electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cations. So you can see here how we can derive the derivation here. So first of all, let us write the cell, electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cation. Now this cell is having the two hydrogen electrodes having the electrolyte hydrogen chloride with different activities. So HCl with activity A1 and HCl with activity A2. So you can see here, this is the cell, electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cation. Okay, so we can represent the cell in this way. This is having negative polarity and this is having positive polarity. Negative polarity indicates electrons are released here, and positive polarity indicates electrons are added here. Now in this case, A1 is greater than A2. A1 is greater than A2. It means HCl with activity A1 will be higher than HCl with activity A2. So there is a transfer of hydrogen ion is takes place from LHS to RHS. So transfer of hydrogen ions, T positive number of hydrogen ions can be transferred from LHS to RHS because it is having the greater activity and the speed of the hydrogen ion is greater. So they are moving from LHS to RHS. And now to complete the circuit, the chloride ions are moving from RHS to LHS. So T negative number of the chloride ions are moving from RHS to LHS. Now here electrons are released at the LHS electrode and they are moving towards the RHS electrode. So you can see here the electrons are released at the LHS electrode. So in this way, the current is flowing from LHS to RHS and the circuit is completed by the chloride ions, they carry the negative charge and they are moving from RHS to LHS. So let us going to derive the electrode reaction. To write the electrode reaction, so first reaction taking place at this electrode, so half molecule of hydrogen gas gives hydrogen ion with activity A1 and electron. So this is the oxidation reaction taking place at the LHS electrode, and at the RHS electrode reduction reaction is takes place. So the reduction reaction is hydrogen ion with activity A2 then combine with electron, and there is a formation of half molecule of the hydrogen gas. So let us add these two reactions. And we can obtain the net cell reaction of this concentration cell. So hydrogen gas having the same pressure here on both sides, it is one atmosphere. So it will be cancelled here. Electron are also get cancelled because they are on the both sides. So we can write here the net reaction, hydrogen ion with activity A2 gives hydrogen ion with activity A1. So this is the first chemical change. So we can write here first. Now, as we know, this cell is an electrolyte concentration cell. So there is a transfer of cations and anions. So we know that T positive number of the hydrogen ions are transferred from LHS to RHS. So the second chemical change now, this is first due to the electrode reaction. Now the second chemical change, that is due to transfer of ions, So let us represent this due to transfer of ions first. Transfer of hydrogen ions or migration of hydrogen ions. So T positive number of hydrogen ions with activity A1 goes to T positive number of hydrogen ions with activity A2. Okay. Now we know that T positive plus T negative, transport number of the cation plus transport number of the anion, it is equal to 1. So therefore we can write here transport number of the cation, it is equal to 1 minus T negative. So we can substitute this value here, T positive, it is equal to. So we can write here 1 minus T negative hydrogen ion with activity A1 gives 1 minus T negative, 1 minus T negative of hydrogen ions with activity A2. So this is second chemical change. Now third, due to the transfer of chloride ions, or in this case it is second, due to the transfer of chloride ions. So let us write here due to transfer of chloride ions. So let us show this. As chloride ions are moving from LHS to RHS, because to complete the circuit, so chloride ions are moving from RHS to LHS. So we can write here T negative number of chloride ions with activity A2 goes to T negative number of chloride ions with activity A1. So this is the due to the transfer of chloride ions. So we can give the number to this 3. So the net chemical change can be obtained by adding 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So let us add here 1, 2 and 3. So that is the net chemical change we can write here. So 1 it is hydrogen ion with activity A2. The left side it is hydrogen ion, you can see hydrogen ion with activity A2. Then second plus 1 minus T negative plus 1 minus T negative of hydrogen ion with activity A1. With activity A1 and this equation 3, the left side plus T negative number of chloride ions with activity A2. This is the left side. Then we can write here add right side. So H plus ion with activity A1, H plus ion with activity A1 plus this 1 minus T negative of plus 1 minus T negative of hydrogen ion with activity A2. With activity A2 here, and this T negative of chloride ions with activity A1. T negative number of chloride ions with activity A1. So let us simplify this. Okay, we can simplify this now. So it is H plus ion with activity A1, it remains as it. Then this is, can we simplify? Plus H plus ion, this is A2, H plus ion with activity A1, H plus ion with activity A1, minus T negative of H plus ion with activity A1, then plus T negative of chloride ions with activity A2, it remains as it. On to the right hand side, this is H plus ion with activity A1, H plus ion with activity A1, then this is H plus ion with activity A2, H plus ion with activity A2, then this is minus T negative of H plus ion with activity A2 and plus T negative of Cl minus ion with activity A1. So we have to write correct activities here. Now let us cancel some terms. Hydrogen ion with activity A2, hydrogen ion with activity A2, it is on both sides. Hydrogen ion with activity A1, hydrogen ion with activity A1 get cancelled. And let us transfer the terms. This negative term should be taken onto this side. And this negative term taken on these sides. On the same side, we have to collect the A2 terms and A1 terms. So we can write here, taking on this side this. So we can write here, T negative of hydrogen ions with activity A2. It goes to this side. Then this T negative of the chloride ions with activity A2. So this is on this side, it becomes positive here. So T negative of hydrogen ions with activity A1 plus this T negative of chloride ions with activity A1. So we can simplify this. T negative is common here. So we can write here T negative of HCl, hydrogen chloride electrolyte with activity A2 gives T negative of HCl with activity A1. So this is the net chemical change. And suppose that this is 4. Now we can apply the Nernst equation to this net chemical change or net chemical reaction. What is the meaning of this? T negative of hydrogen chloride get a transfer with activity A2 to the T negative of HCl with activity A1. Now we can apply the Nernst equation to this. So let us apply the Nernst equation to this. Let us apply the Nernst equation to this. So we can write in this way here. Nernst equation to this cell reaction. So it is equal to Nernst equation with the cell reaction. It becomes in this way. It can be written as T negative of HCl with activity A2 gives T negative of HCl with activity A1. Okay. This is equation 4. Apply the Nernst equation to this. So EMF of the cell, it is equal to standard EMF of the cell minus 2.303 RT upon NF. In this case, N equal to 1 because only one electron is released at the left hand side electrode. Log to the base 10. The reaction quotient QA. This is the Nernst equation. Actually, Nernst equation will be like this. But in this case, N it is equal to 1. And the reaction quotient QA is equal to activity of the product divided by activity of the reactant. So we can write this A1 divided by A2 raised to T negative, where T negative it is the transport number of the anion. So reaction quotient, it is the ratio of activity of the product. So A1 raised to T negative divided by A2 raised to T negative. So it can be written as A1 upon A2 raised to T negative. So substitute this into this equation and N equal to 1. So we can write EMF of the cell, it is equal to standard EMF of the cell, standard EMF of the cell minus 2.303 RT upon F, 2.303 RT upon F log to the base 10. So it is A1 upon A2 raised to T negative. A1 upon A2 raised to T negative. Now for concentration cell, we know that the standard EMF of the cell becomes equal to zero because both the electrodes are same. So standard EMF of the cell becomes equal to 0.0 volt. So the above equation can be written as, so EMF of the cell, it is equal to minus 2.303 RT upon F, minus 2.303 RT upon F log to the base 10, A1 upon A2 raised to T negative. Now we can modify this equation, changing the sign here. Denominator goes to the numerator. So we can write the equation in this way. EMF of the cell, it is equal to 2.303 RT upon F log of A2 upon A1 raised to T negative. Once again, we can simplify this equation. Now suppose that this is equation 4. So this is 5. Okay. So this is 6. So we can simplify equation 6 now. So EMF of the cell, it is equal to EMF of the cell, it is equal to, so T negative, it is raised to power here. So we can take T negative here. So we can write the equation in this way. T negative into 2.303 RT upon F log of, log to the base 10, A2 upon A1. So we can write the equation in this way. Now we can write EMF of the cell at 298 Kelvin. Suppose that temperature it is equal to 298 Kelvin. So EMF of the cell at 298 Kelvin, that is 25 degree centigrade, it is equal to. So T negative into this factor by putting the temperature 298, R value 8.314 Faraday, 96,500 coulombs. Okay. So this factor, it is equal to 0.0592 divided by 1. So log of A2 upon A1, where A1 and A2 are the activities of the electrolyte HCl here. A1 is the activity of the electrolyte hydrogen chloride. Now, HCl is a univalent electrolyte. Hydrogen chloride, it is a univalent electrolyte. So for univalent electrolyte, the activity expression for the activity becomes equal to activity, it is equal to M plus into M into gamma square, M into gamma square, where M is the molarity and gamma it is the activity coefficient. So therefore we can write here A1, it is equal to M1 into gamma 1 bracket square, then A2, it is equal to M2 into gamma 2 bracket square. So we can put these values into this equation because A1 and A2 are the activities of the electrolyte. So EMF of the cell becomes equal to T negative into 0.0592 divided by 1 log of, so it is M2 gamma 2 divided by M1 gamma 1, okay, bracket square. So we can write in this way and we can simplify this. The last step will be EMF of the cell, it is equal to 2T negative into 0.0592 divided by 1. This 2 should be taken here, 2 log means 2 should be multiplied here. So log of M2 gamma 2 divided by M1 gamma 1. So this is the final equation, EMF of the cell at 298 Kelvin. So this is the expression for EMF of electrolyte concentration cell with a transparence reversible to cation. This is the derivation for EMF of a cell, electrolyte concentration cell with a transparence reversible to cation. 2T negative into 0.0592 log to the base 10 M2 gamma 2 divided by M1 gamma 1, where M1 and M2 are the molarities and gamma 1 and gamma 2 are the activity coefficients of the electrolytes. So in this way, we derive here the derivation for electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cation. So you can see here, the given cell is given here and we already derived the derivation for that. The given cell consists of two hydrogen gas electrodes in contact with HCl solutions of different activities A1 and A2. As the two solutions are in direct contact with each other through porous partition, this is the porous partition. The transfer of electrolyte takes place from one compartment to the other compartment. Now this cell is reversible to hydrogen ions. Okay. From the electrode reaction, we can say that it is a reversible to hydrogen ions. So let us see the electrode reaction here. Okay. So hydrogen ion with activity A2 gives hydrogen ion with activity A1. This is oxidation reaction, reduction reaction, as already we have explained these reactions. Now in this cell, the electrons are liberated at the LHS side, LHS electrode. Okay. So they are moving from LHE to RHE through the external circuit. And to complete the circuit, the T negative gram of chloride ions are moving from RHS to LHS across the boundary or right to left. And T positive gram of hydrogen ions are moved from left to right because A1 is greater than A2. So these reactions can be represented in this way here. You can see and we simplify this. And finally, we obtain here T negative gram of HCl with activity A2 gives T negative gram of HCl with activity A1. Okay. And according to this, we can write the equilibrium constant or reaction quotient. So it is activity of HCl with A1 divided by A2 raised to T negative. And we simplify, we substitute this into the Nernst equation. And we can simplify the Nernst equation. And final derivation you can see here. EMF of the cell or ET. ET means transference. Electrolyte concentration cell with the transference. This ET stands for. Okay. ET. So the final derivation it is electrolyte concentration cell with the transference reversible to cation. It is equal to 2T negative into 0.0592 divided by 1 log of what is M2 gamma 2 divided by M1 gamma 1. So this is our final derivation you can see here. So in this way we derive here the derivation for electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cation.